Let's have a look at you. Doctors make the worst patients.
Not everyone gets to live.
Hey, everybody. My name's Jimmy. I'm down here in the Doom Guardian's dungeon. And tonight I'm introducing Dead Walk Talk number 27, brought to you by the guys from Doom Guardian's Horror Emporium, who at this moment are in the bathroom getting cleaned up after a hard day of fighting evil. Yeah, so they got me to do the work again. I'm here to introduce an episode. The episode for The Walking Dead is called Internment. And, this might not be a PG episode, because they didn't have time to clean up. It was a hard day of fighting evil, and I know what that's like, you know. It gets really dirty out there. So, stay tuned for, you know, Dead Walk Talk number 27.
Whenever life gets you down, Mrs. Brown, and things seem hard or tough, and people are stupid, obnoxious, or daft, and you feel that you've had quite enough, just remember that you're standing on a planet that's evolving and revolving at 900 miles an hour, that's orbiting at 19 miles a second, so it's reckoned a sun that is the source of all our power.
I'll tell you, chap, episode number 27 of the Dead Walk Talk is pretty cool, I think.
It's a long time and running, oh yeah.
The Walking Dead's Internment was pretty cool. What do you think?
I don't know. What's this? Season 3 or 4?
Season
4.
Yeah, episode
5?
Yeah,
what's going on over here?
Hey! Thanks for joining us.
Hey, easy on the burritos.
Okay. What'd you reading? I brought the newspaper for a reason.
Okay. So what'd you think about The Walking Dead?
This episode, let me think now. To me, it was more just Herschel's awakening.
I mean, I was sure you were just going to be a dead foolish man.
I can't tell if that's a compliment.
Right, let's be honest. We might as well just entitle it Welcome to Herschel. I really enjoyed it. It finally brought him out of his Bible-thumping shell.
Caleb, we need the gun! Here's the serve. Here's the pitch. And he scores!
It awakened him to the fact that he has to start to participate in this zombie apocalypse. And light a match. I knew Glenn was going to survive. I'm a little ticked off that the doctor, Caleb, ended up passing on.
Okay, Herschel. Have a look.
It's too bad, because I actually liked him quite a bit. I thought he might be a nice addition to it. But they just seem to continue with that. They continue with that just normal group of people. They're not expanding. What they should be doing is adding one and deleting one. But that's just neither here nor there. Probably the best episode I've seen in the jail. And just because it was very isolated. It made you feel uncomfortable. Right? Every door was locked. Maggie ends up jamming the axe. I mean, it made for a very difficult situation. Almost like you were, you know, yourself locked in. What'd you think?
The sun and you and me and all the stars that we can see are moving at a million miles a day in an outer spiral arm at 40,000 miles an hour of the galaxy we call the Milky Way.
Well, I'll tell you what I think. I thought this was the best episode I've seen probably in the last, I don't know, 2 episodes? Got some shaving cream in my eyes there. I'll tell you, it was non-stop action. It had everything. It had zombies. That is a nice look. It had tons of zombies.
Holy crap, Hap. You're right, look at that. That is tons of zombies, even by Doom Guardian standards.
They actually broke into the prison. You know what I mean? Rick and the boy there kind of got together.
All right, listen to me. Magazine goes in here, releases here. Make sure it latches.
And it was a big episode for Herschel. So, I mean, I was goosebumps. I think I was telling you earlier, sometimes you watch the show and they break to a commercial and you're like, meh, whatever. But, I mean, I was actually pissed when they broke the commercials in this episode because you just wanted the action to keep going.
Yeah, you didn't want to stop.
No, so, I mean, this is 10 out of 10 for me. Best episode this season and probably the best episode, well, this episode killed all last season. I don't think they had an episode. That, yeah, so if they keep this pace from, you know what I mean? Like, every episode's not going to be like this one, but I really thought this was the titties. So, what'd you think about it?
Our galaxy itself contains 100 billion stars. It's 100,000 light years side to side. It bulges in the middle, 16,000 light years thick, but out by us it's just 3,000 light years wide. We're 30,000 light years from galactic central point. We go round every 200 million years. And our galaxy is only one of millions of billions in this amazing and expanding universe.
Okay, I'll tell you what I thought. I know I've been rather, you know, un-Walking Dead-ish for the last little while, but this episode gave me hope for The Walking Dead. I loved when the fence came down. I loved when Rick and Carl took out the zombies like they should have done like 40 episodes ago. Or it seems like 40 episodes ago. Thought everything was cool in the cell block with Herschel. I was hoping that they would get to the whole thing with Daryl, you know, but they didn't until the end. And
you smell something?
We got to take showers with those. But you know, I thought it was all in all. I thought if they keep doing this. With the rest of these episodes this year, I'll be a very happy man. I'll be re-walking deaded.
I like the way they delayed the whole Carol issue for an entire episode.
Yeah.
Instead of following this typical chapter after chapter, sequential style storytelling, it to me is very monotonous. They threw something else in that was very pivotal. They developed this Herschel angle. They also developed the Carl and the Rick angle, right? Rejuvenating their bond as parents. That, and I mean, you know, like you said, using a gun, the rack of cart and or the cart of guns.
Well, I still don't know if what they did to Carol was a good idea. You know what I mean? I still think that might be problematic, but whatever. I mean, everybody seems to be siding with Rick so far, except for Daryl hasn't found out. But I don't know. I thought it was a great episode.
Shit's gonna hit the fan when Daryl finds out.
The shit's hitting the fan now.
Well, you saw the look at the end, right? That build. See, I like that. I like the way they just kind of passed it over for an entire episode.
And for everybody, like we were talking about the governor earlier, I think in episode six.
Yeah.
Was it season? Yeah, I don't know. Well, it was the first or second one that we did for this season. We were talking about the governor, and at the end of this one, we know he's going to be there next week, folks.
Yeah.
Governor's coming back.
But they haven't touched on Michonne for quite a while, right? She's just been kind of like a superfluous little character. So, about time they brought her back in for all the Michonne fans. I'm starting to like her. I wonder about this one-eyed man who's kind of a retard doesn't really seem to lead a new story for me. So, anyway.
What are your thoughts about the next episode?
I think he's talking to you.
To me? Hey, I love this new shampoo.
Wow.
This has got a lot of body. It's a lot of conditioner.
Oh, this is fantastic.
Is it color safe?
Anyways, what did you just say?
What are your thoughts about the next episode? What do you think is going to happen?
Oh, well, I think the governor's back, going to get involved, and I don't know. I think he's finally starting to question a good book there.
Son of a bitch.
At the end, he was trying to look at it and couldn't, broke down.
That's what I was hoping.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It's a conundrum, right? I think he's allowed to see a little bit of doubt in it, but he's going to find it again.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all I know is, I think that this particular episode is the first step in the death knell of the prison, because mm-hmm. the fence came down, and they didn't have time to fix it. There's still all kinds of people that are down because of the flu.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the governor's there. I think this is... I'm hoping that it's the end of the prison.
Yeah,
that,
this is...
That we're going to get out of there. So.
Well, from the clip, governor's burning something. If he's not burning Woodbury, what's he burning, right? Which is going to be the next step.
Yep. Right? Something big's happening.
Yeah.
All the zombies busting through.
Something big's always happening. Hey, John!
Yep.
When you fight evil.
And it's not just my hair.
Something's big's happening right in here.
Give me a second.
This man ate more burritos today than you can have. C-ration burritos, because we're in the back of a CH-11-104 chopper.
That's right.
So stay tuned. Stay tuned to more episodes of Dead Walk Talk. We got some Doom Gorham report coming at you soon too. We're scouting locations, and you know, if you like what you see, subscribe. Let us know what you want us to review, and remember, kids, the undead are nothing to mess with.
Stay scared.
You gotta stay clean as well. Because when you're in the field, infection comes from wounds.
Hygiene goes a long way in the battle of
Absolutely.
Zombies.
Alright. Don't let this fool you.
There's some maidens out there that need
prepared.
To be saved.
We're always prepared at Doom Gorham's.
Toilet paper, where is it? There it is.
I didn't pick any up. Uh-oh. Did you pick some up?
No, I gotta sleep.
Oh, man.
Two, jeez. Three. That's your ration for the week there. One ply.
Stay scared.
Stay scared.
Stay scared.
The universe itself keeps on expanding and expanding in all of the directions it can whiz. As fast as it can go, at the speed of light, you know. 12 million miles a minute, and that's the fastest speed there is. So remember when you're feeling very small and insecure, how amazingly unlikely is your birth. And pray that there's intelligent life somewhere up in space, 'cause there's bugger all down here on Earth.